newts are sort of iconic. One of the most toxic animals in the world. They're long-lived, and they undergo enormous changes that are related to hormones used by humans themselves. I've been studying newts for literally decades. About 50 years, to be exact. When it's time for the breeding season, hormones start changing them. It drives the males to the water. Their tail starts growing. Their arms get stronger for holding on to the female. The male is attracted by the scent of a ripe female. He then grabs onto her, holds onto her behind her armpits, and begins moving with her and rubbing his chin on the top of her head. She doesn't readily accept him until he's shown his stuff. When she's sufficiently stimulated, he begins walking along the bottom of the pond, and she'll follow him. And as he walks, he deposits little packages of sperm, and she walks over and picks them up, and goes off and lays her egg, and they get fertilized in the female as they pass out of her body. California newts. I've been studying newts for literally decades. I love the way they look. I love the way they do their thing in front of us. They just turn me on. Turn me on. They just turn me on. I love the way they look. I love the way they do their thing in front of us. They just turn me on. Time for the breeding season.